What's happening, YouTube? Thanks for stopping back by the channel today, right here with the Rust Belt Mechanic. We are continuing our series with this week's Nifty Tools of the Week. We've got a nice plethora. We've got four banging tools here for you guys to check out. Some new to the market, some you might have already seen before, but they've been nifty enough to help me out this week at work. Make sure you guys stay tuned to check these out. First nifty tool that we're going to be coming to this week is going to be the Pros Kit CP382. This is a handheld zip tie tension cutter tool. I guess that's if you want to, you know, the way you really want to call it. What it does is you insert the zip ties into the tool. It pulls the zip ties tight to the correct tension, which is fully adjustable here on the handle. You've got a setting anywhere from like 1 to 4. Anywhere from, I think, 3 pounds of pull to about 10 pounds of pull on it. So it's fully adjustable in whatever situation you're working on, whether you're just putting a couple of little wire looms together, you know, or you're working with the plastic conduit that you really don't want to crush, so you want to turn down that tension. You're going to insert your zip tie into the end of the tool, pull the trigger, it's going to pull it to that certain tension, and then flush cut snip the end of the zip tie off, which makes it fantastic for us mechanics who are getting back into the engine bay and working on these things, because this tool is going to flush cut that zip tie off, so no more busted up knuckles, scraped arms, or anything when you're talking about the zip ties that you're installing with this tool. Now, this tool is available in many different outlets, especially over on Amazon. It is available for right around $30. You can pick that up just about anywhere else online that sells any kind of tools. It is a great tool to have in your toolbox. I would definitely recommend for you guys to get one of these if you guys are doing any kind of projects where you're clipping and zipping a whole lot of zip ties. Next tool that we're gonna come to today is gonna be the Thexton Emergency Brake Cable, remover tool for the cables where they crimp in between. So a lot of the emergency brakes, they're too long to have just a single cable, especially on larger trucks. Now this tool, I really, really wish that I would have had when I was taking the cab off of my Duramax, because it would have made getting the emergency brake cable separated in the middle a whole lot easier. Where these emergency brake cables are put together, there is a small crimp end that is crimped, and then these two lines, which are the ends of the steel parts of the cable, slide in together, lock into place, and they're actually usually even crimped a little bit more. So they're kind of a pain to get a hold of and get loose from those connections because the emergency brake is already tight. What this does is you're able to put your cable end into the little forked portion right here, and then all you gotta do is just as simple as pulling the handle, and it's gonna push the end of the cable through the little crimped portion of the emergency brake cable, and it's gonna pop the end right out for you guys. It's a really nifty, easy little tool, and it's actually one of the cheaper tools that I've been showing here on the Nifty Tools of the Week at about 20, 25 bucks or so. It's gonna save you a lot of headaches. Super simple tool, something that you guys really need to have in your box as well if you guys are doing jobs like that. Now, the third tool that we're gonna come to today is our Matco. This is a newer set, the 12-piece hex grip extractor ring set. 12 pieces, all metric, and these things are absolutely fantastic. I've had a chance to use these one or two times throughout this week. This, I would say, is a really good alternative to like the Snap-on FDX sockets. They are made for bolts or fasteners that are up to 80% already rounded off. What these things are gonna be is the outside ring is gonna be a 12-point fastener where you're gonna be able to get your socket onto. And then the inside, as you guys can see here, has all these little teeth, little grippers that are able to grab and grip onto rounded fasteners. Now this piece is from looks like an 8 to a 19 millimeter set, which is, you know, just the standard socket set anyways. The only other thing that you guys are going to have to worry about is you guys are going to have to be able to use a 12 point socket on the outside portion of this. How it works is you're going to have a 2 millimeter size difference in between the fastener and the actual socket or wrench that you're going to be using. If this thing is going to be the 18 millimeter, that is going to be the size of ratchet or socket or whatever you're going to be using on the outside. And that's going to be to remove a 16 millimeter fastener. It's going to be able to grip into there. And the rounded off fasteners are going to be able to come out actually fairly simply. It grips pretty decently, you know, exactly compared to the FDX sockets, where you guys are spending $200-$300 for the set of those FDX sockets, which, you know, in essence fit really snug on those bolts to be able to grip them a whole lot easier. Whereas these, this set coming in at $29.95, is a fantastic alternative. They're really nice, you know, steel, exterior plated, looks like hardened material. So they seem like they're gonna hold up. I will be able to do some more reviews on these if they hold up over the next couple of months or so. But already just getting the initial view on this one, it's gonna be a great alternative to those much more expensive rounded off fastener tools that you're able to get on the market today. I would definitely recommend to at least try and pick up a set of these. Like I said, these are pretty new, but I think they're definitely worth trying out. Now, the fourth and final tool that we're going to come to today is going to be our IPA Tools number 7862 Grease Joint Rejuvenator. This is going to be for all your grease zerks, grease fittings of any type, and they're going to be able to rejuvenate any of the rusty crusty ones that you guys are unable to fill grease into. Now, having a look at this, it's a three-piece set that's going to have your main insertion tool, the tip and the tip extension hose for those hard to get to grease zerks for you. What it's going to do is you're going to be able to fill this thing with a thinner type oil. You don't really want to fill this thing with grease, as the tip and the nozzle will likely clog up for that one, and you won't really be able to actually use this how it's intended to. So you want to pick up some stuff like this. LACO part number 79704 Zoom Spout Oiler. It's going to be a really nice alternative grease or oiling compound that's going to break those grease zerks ball tips actually nice and loose for you. It's going to have a nice little extendable end for you to get into your joints or anywhere that you need it to. So it's going to be able to be used for a lot of other applications also. What you're going to do is you're going to end up pulling the end out of the tool here. You're going to fill this in with the oil, the penetrating oil. You're going to get your slide end put back into the tool, and all you're going to be able to do at that point is put this thing right onto a grease zerk and use a hammer and just hammer right there on the end. And this is going to force that oiling compound to go into the point of the grease zerk and break it free. Going to put some of that oil into the zerk and free everything up for you. At that point, you'll be able to use your normal grease zerk installer, use your grease gun, and oil up the zerks just fantastically. I actually used this on my truck. One of the grease zerks was all frozen and rusted up, and this thing worked fantastically. Thing you want to make sure you do ahead of time is after you fill this thing, it's going to have an air pocket in it. So you're going to want to hold it up, push it until the little pintle end releases the air that's in the top of it, because, you know, if you have a big old pocket of air in it, air is compressible, you hit it and you're just compressing air. So it doesn't work as well that way. So you make sure you get the air out of it, and it works absolutely amazingly. And at the price of about $37-$38, just about anywhere, including Amazon, this is gonna be a really great tool for breaking those rusted grease zerks open to be able to use them freely again. Now, the LACO oil lubricant does not come with it. That's something that I ended up picking up separately to be able to go into it. My Tifco rep ended up selling this one to me. You can pick this up just about anywhere also for, you know, anywhere from $3 to $7. A really great item, and it works. Like I said, I used it on the old Dirty Max and worked awesome. I definitely recommend for you guys to pick one of these up. last portion of this segment here, I really want to be able to shout out a couple of other channels that I feel are just absolutely killing it on YouTube, both in the tools and automotive sector. First, and the one that we're going to come to today is The Maintenance Man. The Maintenance Man doesn't really do automotive, but he definitely does a lot of tools. He does tool reviews, shows you guys how to use them. He's a maintenance guy, so he knows what he's doing. He does this stuff every single day. He does reviews on a lot of off-brand things too, between, you know, the Makitas, DeWalt's, your Milwaukee things. He does an absolutely fantastic job at doing it. He's a great follower of mine, and I would definitely give a thumbs up to him and have you guys go and check him out. Second one I wanted to give a shout out to, a little bit larger channel, it's going to be Gearheads. Gearheads is a fantastic channel when it comes to the automotive sector. He does a lot of nice top five things between cars, automotive fixes, gives you guys things to look out for when purchasing vehicles, stuff that's going to be wrong with those vehicles as well. He does an awesome job, is very detailed. He does live streams as well. He's popped in over at mine and over with Justin Dow as well. He does a great job on his YouTube channel, does good editing skills. Definitely going to be another great channel for you guys to check out also. I know it's been a little while since the Nifty Tools, but this is what we've got a hold of. I appreciate you guys stopping in. We're going to have a whole lot more to be coming here soon. The finishing of the Duramax build, that video is going to be out here really soon also. We're going to be doing some more of the tools that I've done Nifty Tool videos on before. We're going to be doing some in-depth reviews on some of those. I know some of you guys have asked for in-depth reviews and how-to uses on some of those tools. So I'm going to do what you guys really want, and we're going to show you guys how to use these things properly, and a general review of quite a few of them, I would say, will be coming up here really soon. So make sure you guys stay tuned to that one. Make sure you guys go and check me out over on Instagram at Rust Belt Mechanic as well. And if you guys haven't checked it out, me and JRC54 are pretty much doing awesome on our Toolheads Crate Service, which is a monthly subscription crate service for the toolhead, the tool lover in everybody. It's $35.99, and it's going to be coming to you guys every single month. We've been doing a lot of themed boxes between diagnostics, electrical, box cleaning, and we've got tons more ideas coming out to you guys very soon as well. I appreciate you guys tuning in. Make sure you keep watching for more, and as always, you guys stay awesome.